So we use this interactive whiteboard for many things. We can use it for teaching how to read notes, how to read rhythms. So from year 7 we make it a priority that they learn to read music. And we can use this board to teach them to read things. So one of the things we can use is a game called Star Tours, where it teaches them to, as the notes scroll across the screen, they have to quickly name them before the time runs out. Or this one here, Rhythm Blocks, where they're given a rhythm or a melody and they have to arrange the blocks in the right order to make the correct pattern, and then it checks their answer and tells them whether they're right or wrong. As they progress into the levels of further than that, they can start to write their own music. So we use this wonderful program over here called Sibelius. And Sibelius, what this does, it allows, like an artist would have red, blue, green, yellow on an artist's palette, it gives us a group of notes. And these notes can be typed in anywhere that we need to on the page. So as the students get used to reading notes, we ask them to compose with those notes. So these are some selections of students' compositions that I've typed in. So they each get a booklet and they have to write a melody using certain notes. So this one here, if you've seen Pause in Here's a Who, have you seen that movie? There's a line in it that goes, I meant what I said and I said what I meant, and elephant's faithful 100%. So I gave that rhyme to year 7, they had to write notes to it, write a melody. And then they voted and a person got a prize, and this was the top melody. So a girl in year 7 wrote this one. Let's see if it'll play for us. And that was the melody she wrote. So, I meant what I said, and she was able to put that all together to music. Now normally, if you remember back to music class, parents, if you wrote something on a piece of paper, normally you wouldn't get the chance to hear what that would sound like from a flute or a clarinet or a violin. Now we can type it in, press play, and you can hear everything played back to you. So I do junior band on a Friday morning, because what I've been doing is I've wrote all the music out for them. So if I go to here, I can open another score. And this has all the instruments the junior band would have. We've got electric guitar, bass guitar, piano, cymbals, snare drum, trumpet, baritone sax, clarinet, piccolo trumpet, and we've got the whole orchestra there. So if a student turns up and says, oh, Mr. Wright, I forgot my flute music, I can say, no problem, I can print off the flute part. Within 10 seconds, they've got it. I can also listen to it. So normally, again, if a student in year 9, I said, write a piece for junior band, and they wrote it all out, they normally wouldn't get a chance to hear it unless the band performed it. But now, we can hit play. And we can play it back straight away. And we can hear the whole thing. This is what junior band's playing at the moment. And we can see the whole... Here's our percussion. We go further down, we've got guitars and bass guitars. And they like it because they can play as loud as they want. They love this part here. And that's what Sibelius can do for the teachers, but also for the students if they're able to do this as well. So that's just for notation, and then we can lead on from there. But if the teachers wanted to present a new topic, or they wanted to instruct, we call it the concepts of music, we can use something called Keynote on these Macs. We've got a lot of Mac computers here at the school. So using this program, I can just give a blank slate and I say, right, in year 8 today we're going to learn about rock and all the things that make up rock music. And I might pick some really weird examples. So they'll each have some sheets in their booklets, but I can say, all right, click the board. Today we're going to look at dynamic and expressive techniques. Now you might think this is just a PowerPoint, Mr. Wright. Anybody can do this. But this is more than just a PowerPoint. We can use it to interact with musical performances. So as the students go through this, they can fill out definitions and we can talk about them. But then not only do we do definitions, we can actually see it. Yeah.
Hey, this is Herman from Dragon Force, and you are right now at Blender.com. So I'm just gonna play some crazy little noises that we did on our new album, Inhuman Rampage. Check it out. Basically, we make all kind of strange noises on the guitar and we give it kind of video game names because this is cool, yeah. So this one's from the song Through the Fire and Flames, and just before the solo kicks in, we make what we call the Pac-Man noise. So let's have a look at that. It's actually cooler if you combine it with a ghost noise, since Pac-Man is a bit pointless having him on his own. We're gonna try to put Pac-Man and the ghost together, just like the video game.
And as we go on, we can then start to interact, start including more videos, performances, put music up there, get the students to play the music on the board, and instead of just reading from a textbook or reading from their book, we can make it come alive for them.